Once in time there was a girl named Crystal. Not much to her, just a girl from Bristol. Out on a date with a guy from the city that she met on Tinder. Just trying to get busy, just a little fun. It seemed so harmless, didn't want to be alone inside of her darkness. Invited him in, into her place, and they made love. It was it just a mistake? 'Cause 9 months later came a kid named Jake. Stuck together even though she hates. Every single night she comes home to yelling in her face. Every morning she covers up the bruise on her face. Never thought these would be the problems she would face. Hoping every day for a chance to escape, but the time never comes. Only he does. As soon as he's done, he pours his drink up, then goes to his wife's house, the one that he loves. Leaves her with a kid that a good guy dreams of. Leaves her all alone and broken hearted. Tear stains cover up the bloodstained carpet. She pours up shots to forget his face, and she pops up a pill to forget her pain. And when he comes home, she's prepared for the blade. She was too drunk to put dinner on his plate, and she knows she gotta pay for her mistake. But he's not home yet, maybe we could escape. So she packs up the things, everything she can take, and in the backseat she put her boy Jake. Starts the ignition, starts pulling away, dreaming of the freedom that she's fiending to taste. Those green lights never looked so great. Now her only worry is keeping that wheel straight. There's a kid named Hector living in a trailer. Nothing to his life except his girlfriend Taylor. Comes home to his dad and his brother selling pills, but he knows that he's destined to be greater. Studies at the library, reading for his answer. A way out of his house is what he hopes to gather. Surrounded by the negative, but he knows he matters. College or his girl, Hector chose the latter. Hector got a scholarship to study up in Harvard. It was his first chance to get away from his father. His life was so tough, but without his girls harder. He couldn't abandon the reason that he got there. So he stayed back home, rejected what they offer. Still had to live with his drug dealing father. But Hector got down, back on his knee, said to his tailor, "Baby, will you marry me?" Hector finally got a plan to check. No longer had to live check to check to check. He thought he finally passed life's greatest test, till he got home and saw him getting head. He saw the blonde hair, he thought it wasn't true, until he yelled out, "Taylor, is that you?" He thought he had it sealed. He screamed at his bro, he beat him with a pipe before he grabbed the keys to go. Crystal's finally gone, flying down the interstate, hoping she don't get stopped, she gon' blow on A. Hector grabs a bottle, putting gas in the tank, chugs what's left, and finds the interstate. Crystal pulls on the ramp, seems a little shaky, maybe it's just from the pills she's been taking. Hector pulls on, goes a little faster, kinda confused, like this ramp was made backwards. Doesn't think about it because he just wants to fade, doing anything in his power just to get away. How could she do that? She's the reason that I stayed, and my older brother hopes a guy that fucker pays. Crystal cries happy as she looks at her son, just half a second before she turns around stunned. Last thing she sees is Hector's caught face. They almost made it, but he went the wrong way. Cops to the scene, with camera crews inbound. No sign of life, and neither to be found. Only signs of alcohol inside the systems, and they're saying things, I hope nobody'll miss them. Criticize online and on all the covers. Comments saying thank God they hit each other. Only if they knew, they don't know the story. Their lives full of sun, never seen pouring. One always seemed to get more abuse and hugs. The other grew up in a house full of drugs. She had a son, he got accepted into Harvard, but you only know him as two drunk drivers.